Secretary for Curriculum and Instruction, Yusef Justado M. San Antonio. Please allow me to convey my warmest greetings to all of you attending this bootcamp. Of course, let me thank the Executive Director of ISAI, Ma'am Lilia Habacon, and all the DOST officials who are here, our education partners coming from the industry, from MICHA, and of course, let me acknowledge our partners from Singapore, Temasek, and Nanyang Polytechnic University, and of course, all the government and non-government agencies who are here. My dear teachers, ladies and gentlemen, let me say again on behalf of our secretary, thank you very much for giving your trust to the Department of Education. As I join you for the opening of your bootcamp, let me articulate the instructions of my secretary, of our secretary and USEC DANS, that we appreciate your the involvement of our teachers coming from different schools, coming from different backgrounds, because we believe that this bootcamp is a platform for our teachers in attendance, including all our education partners, to share their ideas and forge partnership and camaraderie. I am just fortunate because I happen to listen to the speeches of other speakers. So after listening to the valuable speeches, I come to realize, and I hope my fellow educators are one with me in saying that the world is now fundamentally different. Earlier, Ma'am Lilia mentioned about the rise of digital literacy. And of course, we heard a big challenge from our education partners from Singapore, mentioning particularly the PISA. As you may know, Singapore always tops the PISA. We are still awaiting for the results of our participation to PISA. Incidentally, in one of the conferences which I had attended with Yusek Nepo, who happened to be our chief of staff and closely overseeing the special programs of our secretary, in that conference, all the Asian countries, that conference built on the sharing of the results of PISA and trying to get experiences from top performers of PISA, particularly Singapore. And after the conference, we made a resolution, except for Singapore, because Singapore did not make this commitment. But the Philippines, just like the other countries, made a resolution that we need to pivot from access to quality. At this juncture, please allow me again to mention the battle cry of our secretary, the provision of access, quality, relevant. Alam ba ng mga teachers to? Dapat na sa puso nyo na to. Shout out tayo sa battle cry natin. Access, quality, relevant, liberating education for all. But as I have said, we need to pivot
from access to quality. As you may know, a lot of efforts have been done to address access. Nakikita nyo naman po, ay sorry ah, I have to deliver my speech in English. You have seen a lot of school buildings that have been constructed. We have created a lot of teaching and non-teaching items and other provisions for our schools. So we have put a lot of efforts to address access. But there are a lot more things to do. As I have said, we forged that commitment. We need to pivot from access to quality. Not only stressing on quality education, but of course we say quality, relevant, and liberating education for all. And so the big question is, and again, after listening to the valuable inputs from our previous speakers, the big question now, particularly for DepEd, is how to understand and respond to these challenges. And of course, I'm very happy to listen to the sharings of Ma'am Zinaida Reyes from UNILAB. Of course, we recognize that UNILAB is one of our partners, particularly in the field of STEM. And of course, from Maynilad, I'm very happy to know that you are accommodating our teachers for their immersion program and for their research project. So again, I would like to take this opportunity to share with you some of the things that DepEd has been doing to address, to pivot from access to quality. For one, we have to inform again all our stakeholders that DepEd, not only DepEd, but the entire country, had embarked into this major educational reform, the implementation of the K-12 program. With the K-12 program, we are giving our school learners that sufficient time to master all the learning concepts as well as to prepare them to become lifelong learners and to prepare them for further education. And at the same time, we are developing middle-level skills for our senior high school graduates who hope to be employed after their senior high school graduation. And again, let me share with everyone, this is not a secret, because it is already a public knowledge or a public secret that DepEd has forged a partnership with Temasek and Nanyang Polytechnic University, and we had that MOA, and very timely, because we are now being joined, we have with us Director Joyce Andaya, who heads our Bureau of Curriculum Development. And as I was saying, Director, it's a public knowledge now, in particularly in our office, in your bureau, that we had forged a partnership with Nanyang University and Temasek for them to train our teachers. And after training the teachers and some officials of DepEd, key officials of the DepEd Central Office, as well as our key officials from the regional offices and school division offices. And after the training of these officials, the training will be rolled out or will be implemented in our public secondary schools. We'll start with our public secondary schools. And what is in store for DepEd, or what is in store for our schools? And of course, what is in store for our school learners? After the training, we envision to enrich our curriculum such that the curriculum will incorporate creative thinking, design thinking, as well as robotics. And of course, earlier we heard the sharings. Again, let me underscore the sharings of our partners from Manila and from Unilab. Let me share to all our stakeholders that one of the features of our 8-12 curriculum is particularly for our science-oriented schools, for both for elementary and secondary, and for senior high school, is the offering of research. And the researches being undertaken by our learners are community-based, such a way that the researches should be a response to the needs of the community. And of course, this should be in collaboration with not only with the community, but with our industry partners. And so, and in addition, let me also mention that one thing that we are planning out with them, and although this has been undertaken in a smaller scale, and we would like to level up. This is the idea of Director Joyce for our teachers, not only be confined inside the four walls of their classrooms, but they should be also immersed in the different industries, so that they will not only be thinking of the concepts, but be able to apply the concepts as well as to absorb the competencies that they can get as they are immersed in our industries. So, of course, in the interest of time, I cannot mention all the things that DepEd is undertaking, as well as the plans of DepEd. But let me assure you that there are a lot of things, a lot of conversation that being undertaken for us to address the world that was being described earlier by our previous speakers. And of course, we keep on telling our stakeholders that the education of it takes a village to educate our learners. And for that, we say DepEd cannot do the work alone, but we need all of you for us to pivot from access to quality. So with that, again, on behalf of our beloved secretary and on behalf of our undersecretary for curriculum and instruction, we would like to take this opportunity to thank all of you for all the good things that you have been doing to DepEd, particularly to our teachers and our learners. And we do hope that we will engage in that continuous effort to improve our education landscape. Magandang umaga po at maraming salamat.
Magandang umaga po at maraming salamat.